Welcome to the live service from Family Worship Center. Family Worship Center is located at Jimmy Swagger Ministries in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. This service is also available live on Sun Life Radio and online at sunlifetv.com. We'll have praise and worship from the Family Worship Center singers and musicians, a time for prayer, plus the anointed preaching of God's Word. Now let's go live to the Family Worship Center sanctuary as the service begins.
Stream of love and it washes. Jesus' wondrous love that brought me down at Jesus' feet. Oh, such wondrous dying love, it asked a sacrifice complete.
Here I give
myself to thee, soul and body thine to be.
It was for me.
It was for me. Your blood was shed on the cross.
On Calvary.
It was for me that Jesus died. Jesus died on the cross of Calvary.
Sing love lifted me, talk about
love lifted me.
Oh, sweet love
lifted me.
I said, have you been lifted this morning? Lifted from the miry clay of sin. Lifted from shame. Lifted from depression. Hallelujah. Has he lifted you this morning? Let him lift you higher this morning as you praise him, as you glorify him. Come on, all over this place, let us worship the King. Let us glorify him. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise you, Lord. We love you. Yes, just praise him this morning. Lord, we thank you. We praise you, Lord. We love you. Just take my life. Take my life and let it.
Take my voice and let me sing.
take my silver. Come on now.
Take my silver and my gold.
Take it, Lord.
Not one mine would I withhold. Won't you take my moments and my days?
we're here to glorify the name of the Lord. There's nothing greater that we could do today than to glorify the name of Jesus Christ, to lift up the name of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, to give him praise and honor for what he's done, for what he is doing, and for what he's going to do. Come on, put your hands together this morning as we worship and glorify the King of Kings. Hallelujah. Turn around and greet somebody and welcome them into the service. We welcome those of you joining us by Sun Life Broadcasting Network, television, radio, internet, wherever in the world you're watching or listening from. We're so glad to have you with us in this live service. We're going to dispense with all of the announcements with the exception of one this morning. All the rest are in the bulletin that you can see. The only one that I will announce is not to forget that the Bible-thon is July the 1st. That's this Friday. And we need all of our phone volunteers. It's very critical. We are completing the outreach for Ghana. 32,962 English Expositor's Bibles for Ghana. And do you realize it won't be much longer? We'll be passing the 1 million mark for our outreach. Oh, you can do better than that. Very soon we will pass 1 million Expositors Outreach Bibles placed in the hands of pastors and workers all over the world. As a pastor, there are at times you have to make announcements that you don't want to make. But we have to announce that our dear brother Greg Coleman went home to be with the Lord Friday afternoon. His funeral will be here in the sanctuary at Family Worship Center on Thursday afternoon at 2 o'clock, and everyone is invited. And you know, Hosea 14:9 says, "The ways of the Lord are right." The ways of the Lord are right. We may not have the answer or the understanding as to why certain things happen on this earth, but the Lord knows all. And everything the Lord does, he does right. We're going to miss this brother. I loved him deeply. He was one of the kindest, most humble, godly men that I've ever met. And so we want to make sure that if you're able to join us Thursday afternoon at 2 o'clock for his, it's not a funeral, it's a celebration. Because Greg is no longer sick. Greg is healed this morning. And he can really sing, "Healing is in this house." Did you hear what I said? He can really sing, "Healing is in this house." He is walking. He is in full strength. And he is able to bow before the Lord. And there's not enough money in the world that he would want to come back for. So it's not going to be a funeral as the world celebrates. It's a celebration. Because he has not really passed on. This human body dies, but the soul and spirit lives forever. And we know where his soul and spirit is. This morning, we want to welcome 100 brand new Family Worship Center Media Church members. 100 from Arkansas, Glenn, Randall, Terry, California, Ashley, Concha, Joanne, Judy, Kimberly, Christine, Mary, Nellie, Rose, Ruby, Colorado, Krista, Connecticut, Deborah, Florida, Annette, Georgia, Kimberly, Lisa, Madge, Otis, Paul, Polly, Timmy, Wylene, Illinois, Terry, Kentucky, Tabitha, Virginia, Louisiana, Kate, Tammy, Maryland, Angie, Cody, Nana, Ronnie, Shelby, Massachusetts, Colette, Josephine and Marie.
And from Oklahoma, Jesse, John, Cheryl. From Pennsylvania, Wayne. From Puerto Rico, Lewis. From South Carolina, Cassandra. Charlotte, John, Joshua. From Tennessee, Melba, Michael, Patricia. From Texas, Geraldine, Mary, Shirley, Stacy. From Virginia, Evelyn, John, Juanita, William. From Washington, Donna, HK, Judah, Marcella, Trinidad. From Australia, Jennifer. From Ghana, John. From Ireland, Joan. From South Africa, Bridget, Johannes. From the United Kingdom, Alexander, Catherine, June, Loretta, Martin, and Maurice. Zambia, Claire, and Mwamba. From Zimbabwe, Nyasa. Got it right. Thank the Lord. Let's stand, Family Worship Center. Let's welcome all of these media church members. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Let me just say a quick word about our brother that just went to heaven, and that's where he's at. He's in heaven. And that's what this church is all about, because we're not going to always occupy earth, because there's going to come a day and time that we're going to change locations. And I'll tell you, we rejoice when someone changes locations and goes to be with the Lord Jesus Christ forever and forever. Mission accomplished, church. That's what this church is all about. We prepare people to go and make heaven their home. Praise God. When we are on that television Friday, we're raising money to send these Bibles to different parts of the world for one purpose, that somebody is going to read that Bible, or some preacher is going to preach a message from that Bible. People are going to hear it. Conviction is going to grip their souls, and they will be saved, born again, into the glorious kingdom of God. Remember this, the kingdom of God is glorious, and it's the only message that delivers a promise, because you're going to live forever, and you're going to live in a perfect place forever. Aren't you thankful for that? Praise God. Amen. Praise God.
We also, this morning, we're going to welcome a brand new addition to Family Worship Center. And I want Jesus and Maria Ibarra to bring Juliana Teresa Ibarra to the platform this morning as we dedicate them to the Lord. These are some of our translators, our Spanish translators that do all the Spanish translating. And we are so glad to have them so much, and we appreciate so much all that they've done for the work of God and the kingdom of God.
Hey, how you doing? You are a doll. Hello, Tiger. How you doing? Yeah, good. Okay. We are so privileged to have you at this ministry. I want you to know that. We are proud in Christ of the work that you do for the cause of Christ. And if you ever don't want her, just give her to me. Okay. She is a doll. Would you bow your heads, please, and say it after me? Heavenly Father, we do solemnly promise by the grace of God to raise this child in the way it ought to go. We ask your help in this eternal endeavor, and we ask it in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Now, can I hold her now? Come here. That's a good girl. my, you are a doll. You know that? You are too pretty. She's smiling. Heavenly Father, as we bring this child before you, we bless her. We pray that she will be blessed physically, domestically, economically, but above all, spiritually, that she will never know the ravages of sin and shame, but only the grace and the glory of God. And now in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, we do dedicate Juliana Teresa Abera to the grace and the glory of God, and say it in Jesus' name, amen and amen.
We are, you know, most of you don't realize it, but while these services are going on, we've got in the studio here voices translating into Spanish, Portuguese, and they do a wonderful work for the Lord. You never see them, but I think we need to give them a hand for all the work they do. Amen. Tonight at 6 o'clock, be back with us. Brother Dale Yusei will be ministering for us. And if you missed the last time that Brother Dale was here, maybe he will use Joseph again. Maybe. He gave an illustration that was one of the greatest. I won't try to explain it. Just means that you don't need to miss the service tonight. Family Worship Center Choir and Resurrection Singers.
Beginning and the end. Oh, how I love that.
may be seated. Jesus said, if you believe on me, you will never die. So Greg Coleman did not die, he just changed addresses. So Greg, well, tell him when you saw me, I was on my way, climbing up that mountain toward that land of endless day. My face toward the sunrise, shadows all behind. So tell them when you saw me, I was on my way. So if you should get to heaven before I see that land, listen to the angels, join their singing band. Well, and when you see my master in that land of endless day, say, Lord, when I saw him, he was on his way. Oh, well, tell them when you saw me, I was on my way. Prayer this morning, I want you to come, please. I want you to come believing God, because he's able to do all things. Jesus is the sweetest name I ever know. And holy name, Lord, John and I agree together as touching my brother. I'm asking for a miracle, Lord, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, touch my sister, oh Lord, touch this young lady by the power of God, my brother, in the name of Jesus. Lord, I pray for my brother this morning, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, that's the reason. Why the Lord loved him so. Heavenly Father, I pray for every person standing here today, everyone by television, whether the cable systems or stations or satellites or the internet all over the world, I ask for healing power to flow into that physical body. We take authority over cancer. We take authority over migraine headaches. We take authority over back disorders. We take authority over every disease in Jesus' name. Be healed by the power of Almighty God. And Lord, we give you the glory in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Praise God, praise God, praise the Lord. You may be seated, bless your heart. Where the healing waters flow, where the joy celestials glow, where there's peace and rest and love, where welcome you today. We're so happy to have you, and pray God's richest blessings upon you. And Grace, are you ready to sing? The song that Gracie is going to sing today was written by Greg, and it portrays the glory of God, the majesty of the Lord Jesus Christ. And Gracie, bless these people.
You brought love.
Wait just a moment, please, Gracie. That's the word that God gave to Moses. I want you to sing that chorus one more time, please. Moses said, "Whom shall I say sent me?" And the Lord said, "You say to them, I am, has sent you." Whatever they need, I am. Whatever you need, I am.
I am the Alpha. I am the Omega.
Thank you, Gracie. Praise God. As Donnie mentioned, the Bible-thon will be this coming Friday. And we're believing God to help us raise the funds for, in round numbers, 33,000 expositor study Bibles. Anything that will help anyone understand the Word of God a little better is valuable. The expositor study Bible will help anyone understand that word to a greater degree. And many of these pastors are trying to pastor a church. They've never seen a Bible school, much less gone to one. They are not able to buy any books that'll help them. They just don't have the money. Some do, but most don't. And the Lord told me, I don't mean I just saw a need and we're filling that need. I meant the Lord spoke to me and said, put an expositor study Bible into the hands of every third world pastor in the world. Glory to God. And that's what we're doing. And as I mentioned Wednesday night, and we got word just a few days ago, Jim Woolsey did, that it's going to be possible by the grace of God to put some expositors' New Testaments into China. Glory to God. Praise the Lord. So thank you for helping us. You by television all over the world, thank you so much. And we're going to receive the tithe and the offerings now. I'll tell you what I want. I want the biggest smile on your face. There you go. You're doing great. And I want to see your right hand. Oh, you did that slowly, but that's good. That's your money getting hand. Would you stand up, please? Would you stand? Heavenly Father, thank you for these people. Thank you for their faithfulness. Thank you, Lord, for what they have done, for what they are doing, and for what they shall do. And I'm asking you to bless every one of them abundantly so, and we ask it all in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Would you come, please? Oh, well, Jesus got a hold of my life, and he won't let me go. There's a line that's been drawn through the ages. On that line stands the old rugged cross. On that cross, where the battle raging, for the name of man's soul that was lost. One more time, please. There's a line that's been drawn through the ages. On that line stands the old rugged cross. for the gain of man's soul or his loss. The headline may never be lost. On one side marches the forces of evil, and all the demons and the devils of eternal hell. But on the other side, all the angels of glory, and they meet on Golgotha's holy hill. It is finished. The is finished, and Jesus is Lord. One more time, please. It is finished. The battle is over. It is finished. There'll be no. It's the end of the conflict. Oh, yes, it is. It is finished, and Jesus is Lord. Yet in my heart, a battle was raging. You see, not all prisoners of war had come home, but I found that these were battlefields of my own making. You see, I didn't know that the battle, the war had been won, praise God. But then I heard, oh, the King of all ages, he had fought all these battles for me. And victory was mine for the asking. And now, praise God, I am free. Is finished, and the battle is over. Ah, it is finished. There'll be no more. Ah, it is finished. It's the end of the conflict. It is.
It is finished. And Jesus is Lord one more time now. It is finished. The battle is over. Ah, it is finished. It's finished, and Jesus is Lord. It is finished. Is finished, and that battle is over. It is finished, and there'll be no more. It is finished. It's the end of the It is finished, and Jesus is Lord. One more time now. It is finished, and that battle is over. It is finished. There'll be no. It's the end of the conflict. Glory to God. It is finished. And Jesus is Lord. It is finished. And Jesus. Is Lord.
Jesus is Lord.
Well, glory. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. I said, praise the Lord. Glory to God. Yet in my heart, a battle was raging. You see, not all prisoners of war had come home. These were battlefields I found that were to my own making. Oh, yes. I didn't know that the war had been won. Then I heard Oh, the King of all ages had fought all these battles for me. He said, son, the victory is yours for the taking. And now, praise the Lord, I am free. It is finished, and this battle is over. Oh, it's finished. Be no more. It is finished. It's the end of the conflict. It is finished. And Jesus is Lord. It is finished. And Jesus is Lord.
Jesus is
Praise God, praise God. Hallelujah to the Lamb. If you have your Bibles this morning, turn with me, please, to the great book of Exodus, Exodus, chapter 2, the 23rd verse. And it came to pass in process of time that the king of Egypt died. And the children of Israel sighed by reason of the bondage. And they cried, and their cry came up unto God by reason of the bondage. And God heard their groaning. And God remembered his covenant with Abraham, with Isaac, and with Jacob. And God looked upon the children of Israel, and God had respect unto them. And I want to use for a subject taken from one of the little songs that we sing here all the time. That's the kind of God that I serve. Hallelujah. Somebody ought to get happy. That's the kind of God that I serve. Would you bow your heads? Heavenly Father, we thank you today. Lord, we give you the praise and the glory. We ask that you would help us. Lord, give me physical strength as well as spiritual strength, that I might give to this people what you have given unto me. Lord, as you anoint me to deliver this word, anoint them to hear it and receive it. And I'll ask it all in the gracious name of Jesus Christ. And everyone said amen and amen. Not long after the Lord began to open up to me the message of the cross, he first gave me an understanding of the sin nature, of which at the time I knew nothing. And then he gave me a few days later the solution to this problem of the sin nature, which is the cross of Christ and the cross of Christ alone. And then a few weeks later, he showed me how the Holy Spirit works in all of this, how that the cross is the legal means that gives the Holy Spirit the latitude to do all the things that he does for us, and that our faith must be in Christ and the cross and maintained in Christ and the cross. For if it's not, if it's in something else, Well, then, really, in the eyes of God, we are committing spiritual adultery. We are being unfaithful to Christ. What Jesus did at the cross answered every question, solved every problem, and won every battle. Glory to God. And the Holy Spirit works strictly within the framework of the finished work of Christ. But not long after this great illumination, the devil, and he comes as an angel of light. He never comes and says, "I'm the devil." He comes as an angel of light. In other words, he looks like God. He acts like God. He talks like righteousness, but he's not. And he began to speak to me, and I began to hear this in my spirit, that what I was preaching and teaching, and we had just begun a few months earlier teaching this great subject over our radio. We only had two stations then. And he said, "What you're teaching, a few may need it, but most Christians are doing great. They don't need what you're talking about." And I didn't say anything about it to anyone, but I began to wonder, well, is this the Lord telling me this? And is it right that most, on the outward, it looks good? And one Sunday night, Donnie was preaching. He wasn't preaching on the deliverance of the children of Israel, but he happened to mention in the course of his message, and I was sitting right beside Francis, the words that God gave to Moses and to Aaron to give to Pharaoh, "Let my people go." And whenever he said that, all of a sudden the Spirit of God came over me and I literally began to sob. I don't mean just weep, I mean sob. And the Lord spoke to me and said, "That voice that you've been hearing is the evil one." He said, "My people," and I'm speaking of those who truly love God, "my people are slaves today to the sin nature. And as the children of Israel were slaves to Pharaoh, that's the condition in which my people now find themselves." It shook me. Lord, it couldn't be that bad, but it is that bad. Let me say it again. The children of Israel were slaves to Pharaoh. They were not just indentured servants, they were slaves. Sometime back in the great city of Cairo, Egypt, we were taken to the most monstrous hole in the ground I've ever seen. It must have been 5 times as deep as this church, 5 times as long and as wide. It was huge. And our lady guide, an Egyptian lady, she said, "Most of the pyramids and the treasure cities of Egypt, this is where the stone came from." Not altogether, but a great part of it. I looked at that thing and I asked her, I said, "Is it possible that the children of Israel, that they as slaves cut stones out of this quarry to build the treasure cities of Egypt?" For the Bible said that's what they did. She stood there for a few moments and said, "Reverend Swaggart, it's not only possible, it's almost certain. They were slaves." The majority, well, let me say it another way. Unless you understand the message of the cross. Unless you understand it, it's not difficult. It's not some great theological thing. One Baptist preacher said the other day, and he said it right. He said, people do not reject the cross on theological grounds. They reject it on moral grounds. Let's say that again. Theological means it's too difficult to understand. That's not the reason for rejection. It's a moral problem, and that moral problem is pride and self-righteousness. Did you hear what I just stated? It's pride and self-righteousness. And he said, my people are in the same condition. They're slaves to their passions. Yes, there are exceptions, of course, but for the most part, they are slaves to their passions, and it's a war that's raging in their soul because they don't understand the cross of Christ. And let me tell you something. Just as surely as God called Moses from the backside of the desert after being in that wasteland for 40 years to go to Egypt, one man, and to release every child of Israel, all of them. Just as surely as God did that, he has raised up this message of the cross and this ministry to go to the whole world to set the captive free. I believe that. It's time that every child of God be freed. The Bible doesn't teach sinless perfection, but it does teach that sin shall not have dominion over you. And the Lord wants you to be free. He paid that price as Calvary's cross, not that you be bound by a bondage of darkness. They cried to the Lord by reason of their bondage. I don't care what it is, if it's alcohol. A dear lady wrote us the other day, Jim Woolsey. I don't know how he got it, but he got the letter. She said, my husband has been saved and baptized with the Holy Spirit for 18 years. And she said, maybe some would say he wasn't saved, but she said, I know he is. Now listen to this now. She said, and he was struggling with alcohol. He was struggling with it. For 18 years, he struggled with it, trying to stop. And not able to, trying to quit. The powers of sin are so much more powerful than our willpower. She said, if we had told the church, yeah, I know what would have happened had they told the church. Church said, don't come back here no more. Go somewhere else. But let me tell you something, friend. This place here, it's not an execution chamber. It's a hospital. Glory to God. Come unto me, all ye who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me. For I'm meek and lowly in heart, you shall find rest unto your soul. Praise God. By reason of their bondage, she said, when we heard over television the message of the cross, she said, we just sat there, tears rolling down our face. And she said, the upshot is today, My husband is no longer bound by alcohol. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Somebody shout. Somebody praise God. You see, if you don't give up, he won't give up. You say, 18 years? Well, you've been ugly longer than that. I didn't say that. You did. But there's victory in Jesus Christ. He wants you to be free. He paid the price that you be free. And how was that freedom affected in Egypt? Against the mightiest field army on the face of the globe. Against mighty, mighty Pharaoh. Against his crack generals and his charioteers. How in the world could deliverance be brought to pass? It was brought to pass then the same way it is now. When I see the blood, glory to God, I will pass over you. Well, judgment is coming. All will be there. Those who rejected, those who refused. Oh, sinner, hasten. Let Jesus come in and he will pass over you. When I, he found it, see the blood. When I see the blood. When I, glory to God, see the blood. Yes, I will pass over you. Glory to God. The blood stops all judgment. The blood stops the powers of darkness. The blood stops hell. The blood stops Pharaoh. The blood stops sin. The blood cleanses and washes. Take the lamb. Pull the skin from its little body. A lamb for a house. Now notice this. With Adam and Eve and Cain and Abel, it was a lamb for a person. With Israel, it was a lamb for a house. When the law was given, it was a lamb for a nation. But when Jesus came, when Jesus it was a lamb for the whole world. Behold the Lamb of God, which takes away the sin of the whole world. Glory to God. One sacrifice for the whole world, for all time. And keep that lamb for 4 days and look at it. It must not be a blemish about it, because it represents the one who is coming, who will be without sin, holy, harmless, undefiled. Slice it open down the back and pull open the flesh to see if there's even any discoloration. If it is, get another lamb. When you roast it with bitter herbs, with no leaven, every bite of it has to be eaten. And if the household is too small to consume a lamb, well, two houses join together. or three even, because all the lamb must be eaten. You can't accept part of Christ and not all of Him. Well, I like your preaching when you talk about the blood of the Lamb, but I don't care for that speaking in tongues. Don't talk to me. I didn't originate it. He said, I heard a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting, and they began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit of God gave the utterance. It's not my doctrine. Take it back. It is my doctrine, too. But I didn't originate it. I just don't like it. Well, I'm sorry, but I like it. I like it. Well, I can't, I think you got to sin a little bit every day. Well, you go ahead if you want to, but there's a better way. Glory to God. Eat it all. Eat it all. Well, I don't know about this rapture. You talk about millions of people disappearing. Believe what you want. I believe it's going to happen. The Lord shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together within the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. I believe it. Eat it all. Well, I'd like to come to your church. And I watched that television network, Sun Life, all the time. And but what will people say? Oh, I'm going to help you and tell you what they'll say. They'll say you're the craziest, most ignorant, stupid idiot in the whole world to go to that church. That's what they'll say. But who cares what they say? It's what this book says. It's what the power of God says. It's what the anointing of the Holy Ghost says. Eat it all. Eat it all. Eat it all. And when you kill that little fella, put the blood in a basin, take some hyssop, that was grass, kind of a grass-like substance, which grew between the crevices of rocks, and slash it down in the blood, put it on the side door, both side doors, and on the header. Now I want you to hear this. Some of you are going to disagree with me, but that's all right. You'll be the only one who's ever disagreed with me, so. Now you made me forget what I was about to say. Well, you say, Donnie, what was I about to say? Yeah. Blow the rope. Here it is. Thank you. He gave it to me. I kind of think there are going to be more people in heaven than you think. There's not hardly a church in the world that would have accepted the dying thief. But in his dying moments, he said, Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom. And he was saved. Now listen, there were pretty close to 3 million, 3 million Israelites, counting the children, everybody, the old people, everybody. 3 million. Not a one of them was lost. Every last one. Now, wait a minute now. Some of those scoundrels I wouldn't have bought a used car from. But they made it. And I know a couple of you, oh, I don't like that. Well, your self-righteousness is rising up now. You know, it really wasn't what they had or had not done. Now, don't misunderstand me. The Lord saves you to clean you up and help you to live right. Don't give me that business, well, I can sin all I want to and everything's fine. That's a lot of baloney. But if your faith is in Christ and what he did for you at the cross, glory to God, you're going to make it. Praise the Lord. Now, the second thing, I got to hurry here. The Lord said, well, he didn't really say it, he just did it. He, and Donnie mentioned this last Sunday morning, he healed every sick person among the Israelites, every last one. I'm 81 years old. I get tired quicker than I used to. I'm not feeble, but I don't jump off the high diving board now. Maybe some snow on the roof, but there's still fire in the furnace. That's a dead bunch up there. Have y'all ever looked? But the script... The scripture said there was not a feeble one among them. And I didn't say there wasn't an ugly one among them. It just said there wasn't a feeble one among them. Now, I'm going to be as honest with you as I know how to be. I was healed, gloriously healed when I was about 10 years old. I've told it 50 times, and Francis said 200 times, so I'm not going to tell it again. But I was healed when I was 10 years old. If I was to tell it, this is what I would say, though. Glory to God! Glory to God! I'd been prayed for, I guess, 20 times. To no avail. But that Sunday afternoon, Pastor laid hands on me. It was like a ball of fire went down my head, down through my body. I was never bothered anymore. I don't know why the Lord didn't heal Greg. For Greg and for Terry, I've sought the Lord just about every day since I heard that they were ill for their healing. And we're believing God to raise up Terry. Yeah. Yeah. Now, it's a lot of things I don't understand about healing. But I do, out of all of it, I know that he heals. But I know also he doesn't heal every time. I heard Donnie talking about Smith Wigglesworth. Smith Wigglesworth and Raymond T. Ritchie. God used a lot of people, but the last 100 years, probably those two men saw greater miracles than any others that I'm aware of in the world. Smith Wigglesworth even saw the dead raised, but had kidney stones so bad that they would have to sometimes help him off the platform into a back room and put cold cloths on his head, on his body. The pain would be so awful. Well, I don't understand that. You mean to say he would pray for people and they'd be healed and he wasn't healed himself? That's exactly what I'm saying. I don't understand that. Donnie, this was some years ago, was walking to his office. He looked over and there sat David Nunn. Brother Nunn was a godly brother. Had a giant tent, preached great crusades all over America, just did a great job for the Lord. Tremendous. I held him and hold his memory in high regard. Donnie had a cast on. Broken your ankle?
Fractured it.
That cast, they said, would have to stay on for at least 6 weeks, maybe 2 months. And David saw him and said, "What's wrong with you?" I don't remember what David was here for, but I think of the Bible college. And Donna said, "Well, I've got a fractured ankle." He said, "Come here, boy, let me pray for you." Laid hands on him, and that cast was gone in 2 days. And yet, Brother Nunn suffered a stroke, and which eventually killed him. I was talking with a preacher yesterday. He was telling me about Brother Hibbard in Dallas, Texas. They had over 50,000 testimonies of every kind of disease you could think of healed, and yet he died with cancer. Why did the Lord allow James to be killed? John's brother, not the Lord's brother, but John's brother. Why did he allow him to be killed by Herod? He was in his early 30s. And he delivered Peter just a few weeks after that from the same prison. I don't know. I can't answer that. But despite these questions, I believe he still heals. Glory to God. And I know the day is coming to where that there will not be a sick person in the world when the healer comes back, the Lord Jesus Christ. Glory be to God. There'll be no more death, no more die, no more sickness. Francis was healed 50 years ago. The doctor said, "You've got to have surgery." It was serious. And she said, "No, I'm believing God." He checked her about a month later, said, "Are you the same woman?" Healed. And beside that, she will be 100 years old. And the Lord has kept her beautiful all of these years. Hallelujah! What a mighty God we serve! What a mighty God we serve! And then the second thing the Lord did when he delivered them, I'll tell you what he wants us to be. He said, you go into every Egyptian home. They lived in huts. Not the Egyptians, the Israelites lived in shacks. Their clothing was rags. They were slaves. And knocked on the door. And this is a door I'm knocking on here. Help me a little bit. That's good. You're a good man. Lady comes to the door and says, oh, you're one of the Israelites. Let me give you all the clothes I've got. And these will be for your husband if you're married, but here, take all the most beautiful silk garments, the most beautiful clothing on the face of the earth. They gave it because God didn't want his people coming out dressed as slaves. He wanted them, glory to God, come out dressed like multimillionaires. Woo! My Lord, do you hear that? Glory to God. Hallelujah. You think about it. Dressed as slaves, and they go, and those ladies put on the most beautiful silk dresses. She'll find it after a while. Don't worry about it. And they went out of Egypt dressed to the nines. Glory to God. Why? Because they were God's people. They were his people. They were the people of the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And then number three. The Lord said, now when I give you all these clothes, just hang around another minute or two because they're going to fill your pockets with gold and silver. My Lord, hallelujah, hallelujah. He didn't want any poverty-driven people driven out of Egypt. They came out rich. They came out rich. I think it's Deuteronomy. Maybe it's Leviticus. Maybe it's Numbers. It's in the Bible. He said, when there is no longer the poor among you. Did you hear that? No longer the poor among you. Meaning he was going to bless them so much. Let me tell you something. While I'm here, I might as well go ahead and unload. Some of you would start paying your tithe. Oh, no, preacher, you've started meddling now. Start paying your tithe. The Lord said if you'll pay your tithe, if you'll pay your tithe, if you'll pay your tithe, I will open up the windows of heaven and I will pour on you blessings that are so abundant you won't have room to receive them all. Well, I just don't believe it. You old skinflint. You old miser. I can't imagine anybody what the Lord's done for you that you wouldn't want to give to him. Show you how the Lord works. It was in a Baptist church. And I've got to close. I'm not finished. I'm just tired. Baptist church. Evangelist preached that night. And that day, the pastor told him of his son that had left home running from God. He didn't leave that day. He'd left months before. I don't want any of it. I don't want this Jesus stuff. I don't want it. Left. Like the broken, the parents' hearts, you can imagine. And he said, help me pray that God will bring him back. That night, place was filled. And the evangelist came down to the end of his message, and he'd been preaching on the prodigal son. And he had given just fictitious names to the prodigal son, Zechariah, Matthew, Paul, Ezekiel, whatever he wanted to give it to him. And he was telling the story. And he said, the father looked up, and there came his son, and his name was, and he just went blank. He couldn't remember anything. And he blurted it out. And his name, there he comes, is Little Bud. And all of a sudden, he saw a commotion in the back of the church. And people started weeping and crying. And he saw a young man staggering down the aisle. And it was that pastor's son. And his name was Little Bud. Glory to God. Hallelujah. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. Let me ask you a question. He wants to pull you out of Egypt. He wants to bless you. He wants to help you. You don't have to stay a slave to Pharaoh. You are a child of Almighty God. I don't care how many times you failed, you are a child of God. You don't have to be in bondage anymore. I want everyone to stand, please. Glory to God. I want us to sing it. What a mighty God we serve. And I want you, I don't know the need of your life, but God does. And let me tell you, he's talking to you right now. And I want you to walk down here and stand here. I want you to come as we sing it. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God. Talk to you here and you by television. Brother Swaggart, some of you may say, oh, I wish I was there where I could walk down that aisle. It doesn't matter about that. He's where you are. And you're going to leave this place today victorious. Victory over the world, the flesh, and the devil. Don't doubt it now. Don't say, well, I hope so. No, no, no. By the grace of Almighty God, you won't leave here like you came, in Jesus' name. Praise God. You won't be like you were. Believe that. Heavenly Father, I pray for every man, woman, boy, and girl that stands here today, everyone by television, by radio, by the internet, satellite, all over the world. I take authority over that bondage. They've been in bondage long enough. It may be bondages of a vice. It may be a bondage of poverty. It may be a bondage of sickness, but they've been in that bondage long enough. Be free right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Be free. Now start praising Him for it. Start praising Him for it. Well, what a mighty God we serve.
One more time, and as we leave the sanctuary, and we're going to leave like the children of Israel, in victory, in victory, in victory. Be back with us tonight at 6 o'clock. Brother Dale will be a great blessing. But you that are standing here, you that walk down here, it doesn't matter how many times the enemy has knocked you down. All that matters is how many times you get up. Forgetting those things that are behind, we get up and press toward the mark of the prize of the high calling in Christ Jesus. They're going to sing it one more time. You go out of here claiming your victory and singing, "What a mighty God we serve." We'll see you back tonight at 6 o'clock. Turn around. Love somebody, shake their hands. God bless you.
What a mighty God.
We hope you were blessed and enjoyed this live Family Worship Center service. Family Worship Center in Baton Rouge, Louisiana holds 3 services weekly, Sunday at 10 a.m. and 6 p.m. Central Time, and Wednesday at 7 p.m. Central Time. To become a member of the Family Worship Center Media Church, call 800-288-8350 or go to jsm.org. All services are broadcast live on the Sun Life Broadcasting Network, including Sun Life Radio and online at sunlifetv.com.